Hey, how you doing? My name is Emilio, and today we're going to be talking about Mac versus Windows. We're going to be going through what I think are the pros and cons between each, why I choose to use one over the other, both at home and at work. So we're going to talk about that today. Hopefully you find this helpful. Please remember, as always, to subscribe, clicking on the notification bell to be kept up to date with every video that I am releasing. So most people fall in one of two camps. They're either die-hard Windows fans or they're Mac fanboys and girls. It's very uncommon for somebody to like both very, very passionately. Generally, what I have found is people who love Windows really, really detest the Mac. That's just a thing. And people who love the Mac don't understand why people would use Windows because the Mac is so much better. So there's this battle, there's this divide that is going amongst a whole group of people fighting between Windows and Mac. And really, at the end of the day, it's a computer, right? It's just a piece of hardware and some software that you're using to do your work, to create some home movies, to look at your photos. It's not a real big deal. Yet there are such battles being fought over which one is superior. Now, I'm going to give you my thoughts around the two, but I happen to be a Mac and a Windows lover. I have multiple Mac computers, multiple Windows computers that I'm using at home, at work, in my studio, and I also use Linux. So, if we're looking at the major comparisons between the two, if you go back 10, 15 years, Windows was the clear winner. The Windows operating system had the majority monopoly, like it had the majority of users were using Windows. You would buy a Dell computer, a Lenovo, a HP, and it would be running Windows XP, Windows 7, whatever it was back then, Windows 3.1, even further back. And that's really what people knew. There wasn't too much competition. There was slivers of Apple having their hand in there somewhere. It wasn't as widespread as Windows was. Over the years, that has changed. So back in the day, majority of software, majority of applications and games and things of that nature were being written primarily for the Windows operating system. So people who were running Macs suffered as a result of that. You had a Mac, you wanted to do the same stuff and run the same apps, you couldn't. You couldn't. So this was very, very problematic, especially for people, say, who love gaming, right? They loved playing PC games. They couldn't install Half-Life on their Mac. Like, this is like one of the biggest games of all time, first-person shooters, but you couldn't run it on a Mac. You wanted to run something on your computer, and you were sort of stuck to having to have a Windows computer. Something that a lot of people would love, especially with the Windows ecosystem, is that you could buy any computer. You could buy a HP, a Dell, whatever. You could go to your local PC store, pick up all the parts, buy yourself a motherboard, a CPU, some RAM, a graphics card, a case, right? You could pimp it up with some neon lights and, fans and all this sort of cool stuff. Build it yourself, right? And then install Windows onto it. Later on, you want to increase the resources, you just pull some stuff out, you put more things in. You could install multiple hard drives, you could install a lot more RAM, you could take out the CPU, put in a new CPU, as long as the motherboard could handle a particular CPU. So there was a lot of flexibility in what you could do with Windows. And especially people who wanted to get their hands dirty, tinker around, like to play with the hardware, with the software. There was a lot more flexibility with Windows and the hardware that Windows was sitting on. Apple, on the other hand, was very much around, you use our software, you have to use our hardware. And that's still sort of true to this day. I mean, of course, there are ways, there's like a Hackintosh that you can sort of set up on a Dell or on a HP. You could actually install Mac OS on it if you do want to, but it's not natively supported. So still to this day, if you want to play around with the Mac operating system, you have to buy some Mac hardware. So you're sort of tied into that. You buy the hardware and you're stuck with the software. Now that could have its negatives because you're sort of part of Apple. But at the same time, it's a positive because you've got the same vendor. You've got Apple who is making the hardware and Apple who is making the software. Of course, the hardware, if you're looking at, say, an iMac, for example, Apple is building the chassis and it's designing it. And the stuff that's inside, not all of it will be Apple branded, of course, right? Because they've got partnerships with Intel. So the CPU will be Intel, the graphics cards, all these sort of things will be other brands, but they've more been catered and customized for Apple. Apple has selected that hardware to fit inside of its computer because it knows and trusts that that will work the best for the Mac operating system. So it's a positive and a negative at the same time. While on the Windows front, you've got a vendor such as Dell. Dell build a PC, here's the hardware, here's the stuff. You now have to install Windows onto it. And of course, the beauty of having to install something like Windows, you have to go and install a whole bunch of drivers. Everybody loves this. I'm sure you've all experienced the pain of installing Windows. You're missing drivers. Where do I find the drivers? And you download them and they don't work, or it's the incorrect driver, or it's 32-bit when it should be 64-bit. There's a whole range of stuff. While on Mac, you install Mac OS, it already has pre-configured all of the drivers and it should just work out of the box. One big thing that Steve Jobs used to always say was that it just works. And that's sort of true in a way. You grab a Mac, you buy a Mac, you have it running with Mac OS and it generally just works. You don't have to go and customize it and tinker around with it and sort of figure out how to make this thing run how you want it to run, because it's sort of out of the box, that's how it works. If you look at the Mac today, it is way, way ahead of where it was years ago. The market now is pretty competitive, where Windows is actually competing quite strongly, or Microsoft competes quite strongly with the Mac OS. Windows is still the leader, of course, right? But Mac is gaining ground very, very quickly. The popularity of the Mac, especially in the last number of years, has primarily been as a result of the release of the iPhone. You saw the iPhone getting released and people said, oh, this is cool. And of course the iPhone shot up. It was the number one smartphone for a very, very long time. It still is the number one in a lot of places around the world. Of course, it's now competing very closely with Android, with the Samsung, with Huawei, these sort of companies. But the iPhone is really what opened up the door for people to explore the possibility of the Mac. You know, they would play with the iPhone or even with the iPad and they would go, hey, this is cool. It works. It's so easy to use. Why don't I look into the Mac? They buy a Mac. Wow, this is cool. This is really easy to use. And that's really what helped. It was like the gateway into Mac OS for a lot of people. And still to this day, Mac is continuing to grow. At homes, for personal use, in the business, it's continuing to grow as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if Microsoft don't do something crazy, an amazing, amazing feature upgrade in later versions of Windows. There is a potential where Mac could overtake them. Not right now, but maybe in future. If the trajectory keeps going the way that it's going, there's definitely going to be a bit of competition there. Now, although the Mac OS has grown significantly, there is still from time to time, compatibility issues here and there. Not everything is available on the Mac as yet. Majority of things are. Like in the olden days, you wanted to install a particular piece of software. You couldn't find that software on the Mac. Most of that has sorted itself out. There's either that same software is now available for the Mac, or there's such good competing software that the version of that app, let's say video editing software that's available for Windows, you've got a very good competitor that is created a video software platform for the Mac. So it's now very, very much the same. Where I still do see a little bit of a gap is in the gaming space, especially. If I use an example of Steam, so Steam being the platform where you can go and download and buy a whole bunch of games and play them on your PC, Steam is available for the Mac. And this was big news a number of years ago when Steam said, we're gonna release Steam for Mac. And everyone said, yay, including me, I loved it. I'm like, great, but not every game runs. You can go into the Steam engine and then you will see that there's a lot of games in there. A lot of the leading games are still only gonna work for Windows. So even though you've got Steam, the games themselves won't work on the Mac. Hey, I think that's changing. All right, I think that is changing. So working in IT, I've worked with a lot of staff across many, many companies for a lot of years of my career anyway. The biggest complaint that I hear from Windows users, even my own family and friends, who some of them are diehard Windows fans and refuse to even touch the Mac, is they'll say the Mac is just too confusing. It just doesn't make sense. You know, I'm used to Windows. I then log into a Mac and I don't know where stuff is. How do I do this? How do I do that? Where is this? Where is that? And it's not that those features or those applications are not available on the Mac. They just don't know where to find them. You'll find that most of the stuff that you can do on Windows, you know, where all the features are, Control Panel, Windows Explorer, all these sort of things, there are actually equivalent versions of this on a Mac. Just people don't know. You know, you can do things like copy and paste on Windows. You can also do copy and paste on a Mac. On Windows, you've got Windows Explorer, right? You go in, you've got all your file structure. On the Mac, you've got the Finder. On Windows, you've got Control Panel. On the Mac, you've got System Preferences. On Windows, you've got the Start menu button. On Mac, you've got the little Apple menu button on the top left. So that sort of stuff is very much the same. You know, the little cross to close a window down or to enlarge a window. They're there on Windows, they're there on Mac, but they're on the opposite sides. So as much as it can be frustrating, especially if you're used to Windows, you're used to seeing the cross on one side and then on the Mac, it's on the other side. Ah, it drives me crazy, right? It drives people crazy. It's not a big deal. It's just on the other side. It's just not called Windows Explorer. It's called the Finder. You can still do the same sort of stuff. So what about file types? Think about things like image files, video files, you've got text files, you've got Word files, all of these sort of extensions, right? Each of these files have got an extension, like an image could have a .jpg, like a JPEG, a .gif, a video could be a .avi or a .mov. These sort of extensions, they work across both. Don't worry about it. You'll be able to open up an image the same on Windows as you can on a Mac. Same is true with video files. If you can't open up a video file natively on one or the other, there's generally applications, VLC, for example, where you can install on both Mac or Windows to open up all your movie files. Text editors, TXT files, that's all the same. What will be different is things like the installer files, right? So application installers on Windows, you've got .exe, executable files. On the Mac, they're .dmg files. So that's one difference. So for example, an .exe file, you can't natively open it on a Mac. A .dmg file, you can't open it up on Windows. On Windows, you've got folders. On Mac, you've got folders. You dump files into folders. That's the same. On Windows, you've got shortcuts, right? You right-click, you create a shortcut to a file or a folder. On the Mac, there are shortcuts, but they're called aliases. So once you get past all of that, you'll actually see that the systems aren't that different. The features, the apps, the extensions, the files that you want to be opening, they're pretty much available across both. You know, like if you love Word and Excel and PowerPoint and you go, oh, but that's a Microsoft product. It's going to run only on Windows. Microsoft actually develops Word and Excel and they develop Office for the Mac. So you can still open up all of your Word files, your Excel files across both. Of course, given that you've got the right software installed. Something that can be frustrating to some people is, you know, they'll have a USB stick that was formatted on a Windows PC and they put it into a Mac, then they can't copy files to it. You'll find that the file system that Windows and Apple uses is actually different in the back end. Things such as FAT32 are consistent. You can actually use FAT32 between the two. XFAT, you can use between the two. So these are the back end file systems where how hard drives are formatted. NTFS is a native Windows format. On the Mac, you can read NTFS, but you can't write to NTFS unless you've got specific application. You can actually get an application for the Mac to allow you to read and write NTFS on your Mac. I've actually got a link to it in my description if you are interested in buying that. Really good piece of software. On the Mac, you've got the APFS, or you've got the macOS extended file systems. And similarly, if you have a hard drive, you've got a USB stick that you have formatted on a Mac and you formatted it with that format, you put that into a Windows computer, you won't be able to read it unless you have specific software on Windows to be able to let you run and open up the Apple file system. So that is probably one of the biggest annoyances, I guess, between the two platforms, that the file systems are different. But there are workarounds via third-party applications that do let you do that. Here's another thing. This one a little bit that grinds my gears just a little bit is when people say, oh yeah, but if you get a Mac, you don't need to install antivirus. On Windows, you do. So that's one of the best things about getting a Mac. Years ago, possibly, but it's not because the Mac is more secure necessarily. It's just because Windows was bigger. So people who wanted to go and steal and destroy data on computers, on business computers, they were writing malicious code primarily for Windows because Apple was such a small group of people, diehard fans, that it wasn't worth their time. Now things are changing. You can get antiviruses. I would recommend to go and install an antivirus software, go install some sort of malware protection on a Mac as well as on your PC. Yes, there are still a lot more on Microsoft, on the Windows side. People are still writing a lot more malicious code for that, but it's growing and it's growing very, very quickly on the Mac. So the Macs are not immune. A virus written for Windows probably will not run on the Mac. And a virus written for a Mac will probably not run and cause damage on a Windows computer, but still have antivirus for both. So which one should you choose? Which one is better? Well, it's completely up to you. I'm happy to let you make that decision. If you're at home, if you're wanting one for personal use, think about your primary day-to-day uses of your computer. What are you doing primarily? If you are doing some, you know, if you're wanting to play with photos and movies and TV shows and play around with media, multimedia sort of stuff, do a bit of web browsing, I'd probably say go for a Mac. It's going to be a little bit more expensive, but the software that is around that may work a little bit better. If you're just doing some basic Word editing, you're just wanting to surf the internet a little bit and just open up some spreadsheets, you don't care about sorting out your photos and doing media stuff, maybe go for Windows, they're also cheaper. That's obviously one of the benefits of the Windows ecosystem and the hardware, it's just a lot cheaper. You could probably buy a few computers for the price of one Mac, depending on the specs, of course. In a business, well, that's completely different. Again, it depends on what the business is doing, depends on what your staff are doing. We're not gonna talk about it in this video, but I will be recording another video, sort of as a part two, going a little bit more detail around businesses and why you would choose one over the other. Like, do I pick Macs or Windows? What are the pros and cons between each of those in a workplace? Because computers in a business talk to servers and network gear and all this sort of stuff in the back end. And do I want to go Microsoft or Apple? Like, does it work together in a business? You know, what if you've got 100 computers and they're all mixed? Will they all be able to communicate? Can they all access the file server and my H drive and all these sort of things all at the same time? We're going to talk about that in another video, so stay tuned. That is my summary. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please let me know in the comments below. Shoot me a note, let me know which you prefer. Do you prefer Mac? Do you prefer Windows? Why do you prefer Mac or Windows? Why do you hate Mac if you're a Windows guy, and why do you hate Windows if you're a Mac guy? Remember to like this video if you did like it and click on the subscription button and the bell to be kept up to date with all of my video releases. Really appreciate you spending the time watching this video. Thanks again. We'll see you next time.